Okay.
Good evening, guys. Let's start with today's session. Just give me confirmation you're able to hear me. You're able to see the PPT and you're able to hear me, no, properly. Okay. Now, in the last session, we were discussing about binary string concatenation operator. I guess we have done the discussion. Just we'll go through the slide. I think we have not gone through the slide. Quickly we'll go through the slide. In Java, plus operator is overloaded. Overloaded means it is provided, it is told to do extra work. Means that plus operator will do the normal arithmetic work. Arithmetic work means adding integers and float and byte, short. So it will do the arithmetic addition, but it will also do now extra work of concatenating string. Getting? So therefore we call it as it is overloaded. Getting? It is going to do its standard work. That is, if you write x plus y, where x and y are numeric values. Numeric means they are integers, float, double, char, byte, short. So it will do the standard arithmetic work. But now what Java says, if x and y are strings, then it will do the job of string concatenation. Getting? So if first is a string and second is a string and you are using a plus sign between these two strings, it will do string concatenation and it will give you a result as a new string in which there will be first string followed by second. Getting? So hope I have told you all that. Then the second rule I had told you, that if one is a string and another is a primitive, like another is a primitive value, so is that primitive value also implicitly converted into string? Yes, guys, I am sure I have told you, like if this is 45, a primitive, it is implicitly converted into string and then it will do the normal string concatenation, right? And the third point I told you, that if one is a string and another is a reference variable. Reference variable means it is an object of any class. Let it be an object of any class. If one is a string and another is a object, then here is some magic method called implicitly, which is that magic method which it implicitly gives call to. Can anyone tell me? Do you remember or no? There is one magic method called as toString. Yes or no? And then whatever string that magic method returns, that string and this string is going to get what? Concatenated. I'm sure that I have told you in the last session about this toString. Implicitly that object will give call to this magic method called toString. And then this string and the string which this toString returns, that string and this string is going to get concatenated. I had even told you that, like if E is an object of employee class, so it will search this toString first in the employee class. If it is not found in employee class, then does it go to its automatic parent? And I hope you know that in Java, every class which doesn't have a parent, will it get an automatic parent called object class? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And it will give call to toString from that object class. And if toString is called from object class, then what does that object class toString return? The class name, @, and a hexadecimal hash code. Yes or no? It returns a hexadecimal hash code, @, and this. Even demonstration also I have shown you in the last session. I'm sure told you. And if there is a reference variable containing null, then it will convert that null also to a string. You understanding? A string containing null, N-U-L-L. Okay, so all that points in the last session I had told you, let's quickly go through it. So the binary operator plus is overloaded. Overloaded means it is being given more than one task. Means that operator is told to do additional work. It will do its standard work of arithmetic operation. That is its natural work. What is its natural work? To perform operation on arithmetics. Right? And if you apply the same operator on strings, then it will do the string concatenation. And therefore it is called overloaded. Like if you are working in company and in your team, you are working in a team, and suppose someone in the team leaves the job. Getting? So now till the next person come and occupy that, your manager tells that you only do the work of that person. Means you have to do your work plus you have to do the work of the person who has left. So obviously you are being overloaded. Are we supposed to call you as overloaded? Why? Because you are going to do your standard work plus you have to do the work of someone else also. Same way. So plus is overloaded. It will do its standard work of arithmetic addition as well as it will do the work of string concatenation. Right? See ya. Then, when one of the operand is a string object, the other is automatically converted to string. Implicitly means you don't convert. Implicitly, compiler will convert it to string, which I told you just now. If one is a string and another is not a string, the other one is automatically converted to string and then it will do the string concatenation. Getting? See ya. For an operand of primitive data type, means if one is a string and another is a primitive data type, then that primitive data type is converted to a string object. See here, its value is converted to a string object with a string representation of the value. Like if it is 45, it is integer 45, so it will become string 45, means double quote 45. If it is float 4.5, it will convert to double quote 4.5. Getting? Then, if you have Boolean values, then null reference, they will also get converted to string. Double quote true, double quote false, double quote null. Getting? And if there is a reference variable in which there is a null value, that null value is also converted into string. Right, guys? Okay? And if you have one as a string and another as a reference variable, so does that reference variable implicitly call or does it call one magic method that is toString? And that toString will return your string, that string and the other string will get what? Concatenated. Getting? One demonstration also I have shown you about this. I remember, I guess I have shown you one demonstration. We can check it also. String concat. See, I've given you a demonstration in the last session. Like double quote Ram plus double quote Sita. Both are string. It will do string concatenation. One is string and one is primitive. So primitive will convert to string. 50 will get converted to string. Isn't it, guys? Double quote 45 plus 50. So 50 will get converted to string and then string concatenation. So you'll get output as year as
4550.
Right? Here you'll get output as a string 4550. Here also tell me. One is a string and another is a Boolean value. That Boolean value will get converted into string and it will be 50 true. Right? And this case, tell me, if this is a string and this is a reference variable,
तो इज दिस रेफरेंस वेरिएबल वेर ई इज अ रेफरेंस वेरिएबल बिकॉज इन जावा ऑब्जेक्ट मीन्स रेफरेंस वेरिएबल मीन्स ऑब्जेक्ट ऑलवेज रिमेंबर. तो ई इज कंटेनिंग द रेफरेंस ऑफ दिस एम्प्लॉई ऑब्जेक्ट इजंट इट. यू आर क्रिएटिंग अ एम्प्लॉई ऑब्जेक्ट एंड इट्स रेफरेंस इज केप्ट इन ई. तो डबल कोट हेलो प्लस ई डॉट टू स्ट्रिंग इज इट कॉल्ड इम्प्लिसिटली. If I write double quote hello plus E, so is this E implicitly going to call this two string? And whatever two string is returning, that will come here and that two strings will get joined. And suppose in my class, if there is no two string, getting? So will it give an error or will it call two string from employee's parent? Yes, guys. Now in this context, when I wrote double quote hello plus e dot to string, so obviously it will try to call to string. Here it will try to call to string from employee class because e is object of employee. But in employee class there is no to string. So will it give an error or will it try to search in employee's parent? It will search in employee's parent. And who is the parent of employee? If there is no parent, does Java provide one automatic parent? Yes. And who is the automatic parent? Object. Right or no? So from object class, it will give call to toString. And what does object class toString return? Just now I told class name, @, and a hexadecimal hash code. Does it return like this? Yes or no? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Right? See ya. Is it displaying an hash code? Class name, @, hash code. Getting guys? Theek hai? But instead of that, if in my class I write toString, if in my class there is a toString method, so now will it call toString of employee parent? No, it will call your class toString. And what is your class toString returning? World. So that will come. Isn't it? See you. See. Is your class toString called and it is returning you? World. Okay? Few examples we'll take quickly. See. String. The name contains uranium, space uranium. ठीक है? Now I have written the name, pure and again the name. So will it join this both the string and create a new string and return you? So the name was containing space uranium and this string is space pure. So space pure and space uranium will get concatenated and you'll get this as a new string. Clear? This example is clear to you, I hope. Then, just excuse me.
I have a phone here.
Okay, guys, sorry for interruption. Let's continue. Coming to the examples, see here. So what I said, the first string was space uranium. You are able to see? Presentation is not lost. Oh, very sorry. ठीक है, see you. I hope you are able to see. So the name is space uranium, and this is another string, that is space pure. So when these two strings are concatenated, you'll get this new string.
Sir, you're on mute.
Okay, very sorry, guys. Okay. Just tell me, is the presentation visible? Now you are able to hear me. Coming back to the example, what I said, the name is this string, that is space uranium. And you are just concatenating space pure. This is one string, and the name, another string. And you are concatenating both the string. So what you will get? Space pure, space uranium. Why you are getting space? Because it's already there in the string. It's not explicitly added. It's already there. So when these two strings are concatenated, you'll get this new string. Space pure, space uranium. And that is copied in the name. Means its reference is copied here. Now this is another example. Okay guys, see here. Now plus is coming twice. Will it follow the standard associativity rule? According to the standard associativity, plus is having left to right associativity. So will it do first 100 plus double quote percent? Now in this, can you see one is a string and another is a integer? 100 is an integer, that is primitive, and double quote percent is a string. Is it going to convert implicitly this 100 into string? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
This 100 will get converted into string and it will become double quote 100. Now they both will get joined and you will get a new string 100%. And the name is this thing, space pure uranium. So after that, when all three are concatenated, you will get 100% pure uranium. Do you agree with this? Yes or no? Just give me quick confirmation.
Yes, sir.
Getting?
Yes, sir.
When all the three are concatenated, you'll get 100% pure uranium. So 100 was integer, double quote percent was string. According to the rule I told you, if one is a string and another is a primitive, primitive gets converted to string and then it does the concatenation. So this 100 will get converted into string, so double quote 100 plus double quote percent, so 100%, and the name was containing this thing. So when you join, you'll get this. But now what about this? It looks same, don't you think? Trademark 1 equal to and trademark 2 equal to looks same, but there is only one very small change. That is, this percent is a character, it's not a string. See, whenever it is a double quote, whenever it is delimited, whenever it is enclosed in a double quote, it is a string. And whenever it is enclosed in a single quote, it is character. And if it is a character, here now tell me, is it going to do string concatenation? Your normal arithmetic will take place. Can anyone tell me? This 100 is integer and single quote percent is a character. So tell me, integer plus character is what? Will it do string? Sure, think again. Then what I'm telling you, everything is, you're not understanding. Tell me, 100 plus single quote percent. First of all, tell me the single quote value. Is it a string value or is it a character value?
Sir, character
What
too.
character? Its data type is character. People, you why? What's the issue? You people are learning Python, PHP, C++, and everything at one time. No? So it gets confused. You should try to compare each languages. Don't mix up the languages. Getting? See here, it is a single quote value. It's Java language. It's not Python. Okay? So single quote, when it comes, it is a character. It is not a string object. It's a primitive data type. So tell me, 100 is integer and single quote percent is character. Here concatenation will take place, your normal arithmetic will take place.
Arithmetic.
Arithmetic. And when it is doing arithmetic, will it take the Unicode of percent sign? Whatever the Unicode is.
Yes, sir.
Whatever, 87, 37, whatever, XYZ. Clear? Whatever the Unicode is, will it take that Unicode? And now it will do normal arithmetic addition, not string concatenation. And that's the reason purposely I have given you the example to confuse you people. See here, this first example and the second example look same, but there is one minor change. Percent is written in double quote and here percent is written in single quote. As here it is in double quote, one is integer, one is string. You know that when one is integer, one is string, integer will get converted to string and concatenation will happen. Here concatenation is not going to take place because one is an integer and another is a character. So integer plus character is integer, you know it. Getting? And now whatever answer, maybe it is 167, 137, whatever. Assuming this percent is 37, so when you add it with 100, it will become 137. And the name contains pure uranium. You know, space, pure space, uranium. Now tell me what will happen after these two are added. After these two are added, you'll get 137. And the name is a string. Now what will take place?
String concatenation.
Yes, because the name is string. So now is it going to convert that 137 to a string? And then that string and this string will join. And you'll get 137 pure uranium. Whatever, it's not necessary 137, it can be anything. Okay, okay, luckily it is 137. Means 37 is whose Unicode?
Percent.
30 percent sign. So percent sign Unicode is 37. So 100 plus 37, 137. And 137 plus pure uranium. So this is string and this is integer. So integer plus string, will it convert that integer first to string? And string, you'll get this thing. Okay, I hope you are clear with it. And only the last example, just to tell you that, does this plus also follow the standard associativity only? Which arithmetic plus follow? Now tell me, if you are doing arithmetic addition, like 4 plus 5, plus 3. So how the associativity is? Anyhow, or will it follow one direction, that is left to right? Is it anyhow, like what? Huh, means does it follow anything what it feels, like sometimes 5 plus 3 or sometimes 4 plus 5, whatever, or will it follow one fixed direction? And the fixed direction is left to right. Getting? So the same thing is followed for concatenation also. Getting? So in this case, tell me, will it do 2 plus 2 first? Will it do 2 plus 2 first and make it 4? Or will it keep, we put 2 and 2 together and get one string? And first, will it convert this 2 to a string?
Yes.
Getting? Or very simple example, first I'll take Ram plus 4 plus 4. Will it give you answer RAM 8 or RAM 44? Just quickly tell me.
RAM 44.
Yes, because the associativity here also is left to right only. Isn't it, guys? So therefore, one is a string, another is an integer. Integer will convert to string first. Yes or no? Now concatenation, RAM 4. Now again that 4 will get converted to string, and then string concatenation, and you'll get Ram 44. You understanding, guys? Means what I want to prove over here is that the associativity is standard, that is left to right. Okay, so what will be the answer? We put 2 and 2 together and get 4 or 22?
22.
Okay, so it is clear to you. Now, I hope you have understood. Sure, no? The concept is clear to you.
Yes,
moving on to the next operator. Quickly, the next operator is increment and decrement operator. Okay? Plus, plus, minus, minus. We will talk about this operator. And just don't confuse with this operator in C++. Because in C++, this operator behavior is little bit different. In Java, what the standard rule is, I'll tell you. And just blindly follow that rule, you'll get that answer. Get it? So we will be talking about now increment, decrement. Okay? That is plus, plus, minus, minus. First of all, tell me, is it a unary operator? Isn't it, guys? It's a unary operator. Why it is a unary operator? Because it is going to operate on single operand. As it is going to operate on single operand, it is a unary operator. First point, you have to make it clear. It is a unary operator. Second, operand is always variable. This, I guess in the past session or maybe in past two sessions somewhere, I have told you also. When I was talking about assertion and negation operators, that time also I told you, like minus, minus, and then phi if I write. So here it's not going to do 2 times minus. It will treat it as decrement. And you know that decrement cannot be applied on constant. I told you that time also, if you remember it properly. Okay? So first you have to remember this operator is unary operator and its operand is always variable. Means you cannot apply it on constants and expressions and all. This is illegal. See here, if I write plus plus phi, illegal. Huh, but if someone puts a space between it like this, so then it is a 2-time assertion. So 2-time assertion means it won't act as a increment. So it is illegal. Get it? Or I am writing plus plus 4 plus 5. This is also illegal. You understanding? Clear? So plus plus 4 plus 5 if I write, it is also illegal. Plus plus 5 is illegal. Means you cannot apply it on a, this operator cannot be applied on an expression. You cannot apply it on a constant. It is wrong. It is to be applied only on variable. Getting? And they come in pre and post form. Both. Pre, post. Both notations are there. See here. Plus plus I. I plus plus. Minus minus I, I minus minus. So both form come pre-form and post-form, right? And what these operators do, so they increment or decrement the value of a variable by 1. Getting? This operator increments or decrements the value of a variable by 1. Okay? Only I have to just tell you the behavior, like as it's an operator, is it going to return you some result? Yes, obviously it will return a result. Getting? So only the difference between the pre and the post I have to tell you. Pre increment, post increment, pre decrement, post decrement. Okay? So if you are writing plus plus I, what will happen, see here, getting? What it will do is, it will increment the value of I and then return that I. Okay? What it is going to do, it will increment the value of I by 1 and return I. ठीक है, the result is, what will be the result? Incremented I. Getting? Means I incremented. ठीक है, but the return value, just check what it is doing. As it's a pre-increment, it is incrementing I and then returning the result of I, whatever the I is. But if it is I plus plus, that is post-increment, what it does is, in a temporary, it keeps the current I, then it will increment I by 1 and return the temporary. In that also, I is sure going to get incremented. But the result is, means the outcome is, I incremented. But what you get as a result is the old value of I. Just check carefully. First, I is kept in a temporary. I is incremented by 1. But while returning what it returns, the new I or the old I? The old I. Same is the concept for decrement. Now, I don't have to tell you. Same is the concept for decrement. Getting? So, if it is pre-decrement, it will decrement and then return. And if it is post-decrement, then it will store the current I, decrement and return the old I. Getting? Only that is the difference. Meaning, now tell me, if I am having integer I equal to 5 and j, and I am writing j equal to plus plus I, and I am trying to print both I also and j also. You cannot print like this, by putting a comma. I am just taking an example. Okay? So what will be value of I and what will be value of j? Will both of them be 6? Tell me, guys. Plus plus I. So as it is a pre-increment, it will increment I. And then the incremented value it returns, which is stored in j. So I incremented. What it will become? 6. And that 6 is stored in j. Therefore, both will become 6, 6. But if I make it I plus plus, then remember, it is going to increment I, but it is going to return the old I. So what will get stored in J? 5. And I is incremented, no doubt. I gets incremented by 1, but what it returns? The old I. The old I is 5, that will come in J. Okay? So that is the rule you have to remember. Correct? And in Java, whenever you use all these operators in an expression, so always remember, so simple rule is there. Java has made so simple rule. If you are writing plus plus I, plus I plus plus, plus I plus plus, plus 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 I, something like that. No problem. What Java does is, it will just put bracket on each operation. Understand, guys? What it will do, it will put brackets on each operation and it will take the result of each bracket and add it. That simple rule it is. So suppose if your I is 5, okay? So what it will do, it will put bracket on each operation and take the result. So now tell me, as it is plus plus I, will it give 6? It will first increment and then return the new result. I told you, no? Plus plus I, it increments and return I. I plus plus keeps the old I, increments I and return that old I. Understanding, guys? So when I say plus plus I, is it going to change this I to 6 and give that? When it comes to this bracket, as it is I plus plus, so will it give the result of I 6 and make it 7? What do you say, guys? As it is post-increment, it will give you the current value of I and increment it. Getting? Again, it is post-increment. So will it give that 7 and make it 8? And here, will it make it 9 and give that 9? What do you say, guys?
Yes, sir.
Clear? I hope you're understanding. So it is plus plus I. So it will increment and give you the result. Here it will give you the result and increment. Give the result and increment. Increment and give the result. So what I said, plus plus I. I was 5. It made it 6 first and gave it. Here I plus plus. So it will give you the current value of I and make it 7. Here also it will give you the current value of I and make it 8. Getting? But when you come here, will it give 8 and make 9? Or it will make 9 and then give that 9? First it will increment and then give you. And now whatever result you get for the brackets, all are added and you get the result. So that simple rule it is, you have to remember. So what all points you'll remember? First of all, these both the operators are unary operator. Means they will operate on single operand. ठीक है? Second, it will be operated only on variables. Means their operands are strictly supposed to be variables. Right? Okay? And they come in two flavors. One is pre and another is post. And what is the job of this operator? To increment or to decrement the value of a variable by 1. Getting? And one point I forgot to tell you, that these operators can be applied only on non-Boolean primitives. You can apply it only on non-Boolean primitives. Means you cannot apply it on Boolean also. Only non-Boolean primitive. Like you can apply on byte, short, int, long, float, double and char. You cannot apply it on Boolean. Getting guys? ठीक है? And the difference between the pre and the post I have told you. Pre increments and returns you the answer. And post returns the current value and then increment. And whenever you use all these operators in a complex expression, always remember a bracket is put on it. And the result of the bracket, okay, the result of the bracket is used for further operations. Okay, so coming to this, see here, plus plus I adds 1 to I first. As it is a pre-increment, it will first add 1 to I and then uses the new value of I as the value of the expression. That is the value of that result. Whatever the result is coming, the value of that result will be the new I after incrementing. See, first it will increment I by 1, keep that I in the result and return the result. But if you are writing post increment, J plus plus, in that case, it will return the current J and then increment I by 1. See here, uses the current value of J as the value of the expression and then adds 1 to J. See, will it keep first J in a temporary, then increment J by 1, but while returning, will it return J or will it return result? It will return result. That is, whatever the old value it has kept. So old value, it keeps it, increments and returns the old value. ठीक है? I hope it is clear to you people. Not that difficult. Quick examples, integer I equal to 10. Tell me now. And K equal to plus plus I, plus plus minus minus I. Can anyone tell me? Here, integer I equal to 10. And then I have written integer K equal to plus plus I plus minus minus I. ठीक है? Right guys? And suppose if I write only alone minus minus I, won't make any difference, no? Because in this case, if you put pre or post, won't matter. I is sure going to get decremented. Do you agree with me, guys? If I write this minus minus in pre form or post form, is it by any means going to decrement I by 1?
Yes.
Yes. Only the difference is when you'll store it in something. If you're storing it in something, then that result will be different. Okay? Okay, but anyway, how it is going to work? Tell me. Did I tell you that it will put bracket on each operation? And then will it use the result of that bracket? So what is the result of this bracket as it is pre? So will it increment value of I first and make it 11? Here it is again pre but decrement. So first will it decrement it?
Yes.
And then return it. And then it will add it 21. And then one more time decrement. Yes or no? So will it become 10 again? Now after addition, clear? Not 10, 9. 9. Okay? This is 21. Is it right, guys? 11 plus 10 will come in K, 21. But what about this minus minus I? Will it decrement I by 1? And what was your I now latest?
10.
10. So after decrementing by 1, it will become 9. That simple it is. Okay? Now next, quickly you'll tell me. Integer I equal to 10. Long I equal to 10 and long k equal to I plus 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 I minus minus. And then I'm just writing I plus plus. What do you say? You will tell me the result. Instead of integer, it is taken as long. Okay? And here they have just written I plus plus. And this is also I plus plus I minus minus. Post form I have taken. Right, guys? Now tell me, here also, is it going to apply bracketing rule? And according to that, what is the result of this bracket? Can anyone tell me? I plus plus.
10.
Is it going to be 10? Yes, it is post increment. So as it is post increment, it will give you the current value of I and then increment. So now it becomes 11, but the result of the bracket is 10. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Is the result of the bracket is 10, but the value of I is 11 now. Is I become 11 now? Yes. Coming to this, tell me, what will be the result of that bracket? Will it give you the current value? How 10? 11, no? It's post decrement.
11.
Right? See here. It is going to put a bracket on each operation. I told you. See here. First I is 10. Will it return the current value of I? That is 10. And then make I 11. Post increment. So returns the current value and then increment. This is also post decrement. So will it return the current value of I? What is the current value of I? 11 and make it 10. Getting? So after addition, what will be K?
21.
21. Now tell me, what about I?
21.
I plus plus here. I is just getting incremented. So doesn't matter it is post increment or pre. Is I going to change? Yes or no? So what is the value of I after this operation?
22.
Again, how? I, it's I plus, not, I'm not asking about K, guys. K is going to be 21. 10 plus 11, 21. I plus plus, what is value of I after this?
11.
Then why you are saying 21? Here it is 10, then becomes 11. Here 11 and again makes it 10. And here increment, how much it will become? 11 again. So simple, na? Twice increment, once decrement. So when 10 is twice incremented, it will become 12 and one time decremented again 11. Only the problem is about the result of that bracket. Tell me now, byte b equal to 10, and I'm writing integer I equal to plus plus B. Integer I equal to plus plus B. Okay? So what will be the result of B and the result of I? Can anyone quickly tell me? No, so simple, guys. Integer I equal to plus plus b. Is it a pre-increment? So what will be the value of b after incrementing? It will be 11, and that 11 is stored in I. So I will also become 11. Correct? Is I also going to become 11? Plus plus b. So what is the value of plus plus b? It is 11, pre-increment 11, and 11 stored in I, 11. Getting? Suppose in the same case, I would have written b plus plus, b plus plus. Then also b is going to be 11, but what will be I?
10.
If 10, because it will copy the old value. It will return the old value and then increment. So what will be the old value? 10, that is stored here, and then b becomes 11. If it is post, but as it is pre, it will increment and return the new value. So b is 11, I is 11. Now only one question to you people, guys. Tell me, here in this question, did you observe that why that I is made as integer? Tell me, guys, if I would have returned that I as byte, will it run or will it produce an error? Byte b equal to 10 and byte I equal to plus plus b. If I would have written this, you'll get the same result. Or will it produce an error? Guys, it will.
Error.
Why do you think it will produce an error?
Because integer can't be stored in byte. It will give us narrowing, and narrowing does not take place in Java.
Very good. Clear. Very good. What she said, that this plus plus b, what you have done. Many people think that plus plus b means you are doing incrementing a byte. Let it be you're incrementing the byte, but what is the result data type? As she said, plus plus b. Okay, that b is getting incremented by 1. It is giving you 11, but the result is what data type? Integer. That is the problem, na? In problem nahi, that is the feature of Java. That in Java, the arithmetic result is minimum what? Tell me. Integer, byte plus byte is also integer, byte plus character is also integer. So you know that all in arithmetic topic I have taken. So plus plus b will make it 11, but the result is integer. And that integer you are trying to store it in a byte, it will give you an error. So very properly she said that the result is integer. Integer cannot be stored in a byte, because it's a situation of narrowing, and in Java, automatic narrowing doesn't take place. And therefore, very wisely, you should see that how very wisely they have used instead of byte over here, integer. Okay, now tell me about this, double x equal to 4.5. But please guys, just remember, if you try to do the same thing in C, or in C++, you may not get the same result. That is so confidently I'm telling, you may not get the same result. Because there, they don't follow the bracketing rule. Bracketing rule is not followed, which Java follows. There, they always refer to the memory. Getting? Here, they refer to the bracket result. So tell me, when I've written x is equal to x plus 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 x, x is equal to x plus 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 x. Here also, will it put a bracket on each operation? Bracket on each operand. And now tell me, what is the result of this bracket? 4.5. What is the result of this bracket? 5.5. And when 4.5 and 5.5 both are added, you'll get what as a result? It was 4.5 only, no? Yes. Okay, so quickly tell me, the result of the first bracket x. So what is the value of x now? 4.5. then second bracket plus plus x, no? So 4.5 when added 1 becomes 5.5, and now these two bracket results are added, and after adding what you'll get? 4.5 plus 5.5, is it 10?
10.
But try doing it in C++, you'll get over there 11 answer. Getting? Now I'll not go into detail why the answer is 11 over there. Now about Java, just I'm trying to restrict myself to Java only. Okay? Now quickly answer some multiple choice questions. Which statements are true? Like in your exams, they can give only this one statement only for true or false. Okay, separately they can put. So select three correct answer. Okay, so what do you think? Is the first one right? The result of the expression 1 plus 2 plus double quote 3 would be string 33. Will it follow the standard rule? That is left to right. And as it follows left to right, when it is coming to do the addition of 1 and 2, will it do arithmetic addition, guys?
Yes.
And the result is 3. And now 3 plus double quote 3. This is going to be 3 and this is double quote 3. So is that numeric 3 converted to string 3?
Yes, sir.
1 plus 2 plus double quote 3. This will become, this result will become 3 and this result is 3. Is it going to convert this double quote 3 into string 3? And finally, the result is 3, 3. Do you agree? I hope you agree. Clear? The first one is true. What about the second one? Now, in the case of second one also, the same rule should follow, no? Left to right associativity. So according to left to right associativity, then the final answer should come string 1, 2, 3. What do you say, guys? According to the standard rule, if this is a string, this is number, and this is number. So will it first convert that 2 to string and then do the concatenation? Then again convert that 3 to string and then again concatenation. The final 123 as a string you should get. But whereas they are saying it is string 15. Means they are assuming 2 plus 3 is added first. No, guys, the precedence, the associativity is same as the standard plus. It will not follow anyhow rule. It will follow the left to right rule only. Agreed? Okay? Coming to the, so therefore this is false. Tell me about this. The result of the expression 4 plus 1.0f. is float 5.0f. Do you agree? If you remember the table I had given, and I told that if one of the operand is float but none of them is double, the result is float. So do you agree it is float 5.0?
Yes sir.
Okay, so A is true, C is true. Coming to D. The result of the expression 10 by 9 would be integer 1. Do you agree? Yes. Don't try to apply the same thing in Python. Getting? In Python, the rule may be different. Here, integer divided by integer, the answer is integer. Getting? So it won't go for 1 point something. As both are integer, only the quotient part it will return, that is 1. So this is true, and C is true. So obviously E is false, but why do you think? They are saying the result of the expression single quote A plus 1 would be character B. Do you agree? Tell me. This is a character and this 1 is an integer. So according to the table which I gave, can you tell me? Character plus integer. Character plus integer.
Integer.
Integer. Very good. Clear? Means the table you remember. Right or no? There I've told you. When none of them is float, double or long, The result has to be when none of them is float, double or long, the result has to be integer. So character plus integer is integer. So actually it is integer 98, which is actually Unicode of B, but you have to convert into character and print it. See ya guys. I'll give you a short demo of it. charValue.java I'm writing. ठीक है सिस्टम डॉट आउट डॉट प्रिंट एलन यर वी आर राइटिंग कैरेक्टर ए प्लस वन ठीक है यू विल गेट रिजल्ट 98 नॉट बी गेटिंग गाइस सी Does it give result 98? This proves what? Character plus integer is integer. Suppose you want it as B, so you have to do casting. And casting also not only this much, you have to cast this whole expression. Because if you leave it like this, is casting having more priority? It is a unary operator, so more priority is there. So it will only cast that A, which makes no sense because it's already character. So character casted to character only, no change, and character plus integer is integer. So you have to cast that whole expression. Now first it will do character plus integer, integer that is 98, and 98 converted to character, it will display B. You can check the result. Is it displaying B? I hope you can see small B. Okay, so it is clearly. So this is wrong. The result of the expression A plus 1 would be character B. So no, it is integer 98. Okay. Now quickly tell me about this. See here. What happens when you try to compile and run the following program? K is 1 and this is an expression. Plus plus K plus K plus 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 K. This is assertion. So according to the rule I told you, it will put brackets on each operation. And whatever the result of the bracket is, that it will use for addition. Right? So whatever the result of that bracket is, that it will use it for that addition. So quickly we will see. You will tell me in rough work, this is our rough work, I equal to plus plus k plus k plus 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 k. And what is value of I? 1. No, value of k? 1. Is it going to put bracket on each operation? You have to do rough work like this. Okay? Will it put bracket on each operation? Now what is k already? 1. This is pre-increment. So will it make k as 2 first? And give that result, whatever the new result is. Here, will it give 2 and make k as 3?
Yes.
Right? I hope you are understanding. Here plus plus k, it is pre-increment. So it will increment first k and give the result. Here it will give k and then increment. So what is the current value of k? 2 and then make it 3. And when it comes here, this is just the assertion k. And k is 3 already. Getting? So assertion 3 is 3. Do you agree or no, guys?
Yes.
No, yes. No, then also you tell me. I'll rectify it again. I'll try to prove it how it is. So k is 1. Tell me when we did plus plus k, did it increment this and made it 2 and gave that new k 2? Here, k plus plus, it will give this 2 first and make it 3. And this is just plus k, assertion k. So value of 3, k is 3, assertion 3 is 3. Now it will add it, and the result is how much? The result of I is how much? 2 plus 2 plus 3. How much it is, guys?
7.
Then to select one correct answer, the program will not compile. The compiler will complain about the expression. Not at all. It is a valid expression. Getting? Then it will print 3, it will print 4, it will print 7, it will print 8. So I hope you know it will print 7 because we have done the calculation. Right? And still if you want, you can type and see in your machines. You can type, run and see. Tell me about this. The question is, which is the first incorrect line that will cause a compile time error in the following program? Everything is rules based. Whenever you learn any language, you have to learn the rules of it. And that's the reason we people are not able to talk in English. We cannot talk English properly. Why? Because you have not studied the grammar properly. And if the grammar is perfect, you will speak in that language comfortably. Any language, any. Take it Hindi, take it Marathi, take it Sanskrit, anything. Get it? Any language, so let it be a natural language, let it be an artificial language. First make the rules clear. Your rules of that language should be perfect. And if the rules are clear, any type of question you will be able to solve. Okay. So what they are saying is, which is the first line which is going to generate a compile time error? The compile time error is sure going to come, but which is that first line? Okay? See here, you are assigning this single quote A to C. Now you will say like this is a character, but it will take internally integer only. Nothing like that. It is a character, it will take its Unicode, but that character is within the limit. So it will store it, no issues. You are assigning a character to a character only. Getting? You are assigning a character to an integer. No problem. Because is there here narrowing happening? No, it is widening. I is an integer, it's a wider value. C is a narrow value. I plus plus. But when you will come to C equal to I, it will generate an error. Do you agree with me? This line with label 4, will it generate an error? C equal to I. Now someone previously also answered when I took an example of that byte one. Byte b equal to 10 and then I wrote integer I equal to plus plus b. That time also you should know it. See here, C equal to I. Is it going to give an error? Yes, indeed, it will give an error. I is an integer and C is character. Can you store an integer in a character?
No.
No. It is narrowing problem. This is the problem of narrowing. And therefore, it will generate an error. See, D, the line labeled 4. It is a situation of narrowing. So simple it is. I is an integer and C is a character. And you know that you cannot store a bigger value in a smaller. Will it generate an error? Possible lossy conversion from integer to character? Yes. Okay? Coming back to this. One more example. Tell me. Byte b equal to 128, integer I equal to b, and then SOP I. What do you think? By seeing the code, you feel that it's so simple, three lines code, you are assigning 128 to B, then B to I, and then you are printing it. What happens when you try to compile and run the following code? Okay? See here, the compiler will refuse to compile it since you cannot assign a byte to integer. Is it like that? Do you agree with this point? that you cannot assign a byte to integer, will there be any problem of assigning a byte to integer? No. Why? Byte is a narrow value, integer is a wider. Can you store a small value in a big value? No issues. This is not at all a problem. You can assign a byte to integer. You understanding, guys? Not at all a problem. Okay? Why? Because byte is a small narrow value and int is a wider. The automatic widening is allowed na, in Java. This is not at all a problem. The program will compile and will print 128 when run. Okay? Means it is saying that 128 stored in B and then that 128 stored in I and then printing I. But let's talk about the other options also. See here. The compiler will refuse to compile since 128 is outside the legal range of byte. And this is the problem. See here. Here. The problem is not for I equal to B. The problem is B equal to 128. And is 128 in the legal range of byte? Yes or no? What is the range of byte? Range of byte is 1 minus 128 to plus 127. Range of byte is minus 128 to plus 127. So it is gone beyond the limit. So it is no more in the byte range. So it is automatically an integer. And is it automatically an integer? So integer, can it be stored in a byte? No. Tell me if the same program, I just make a change 128 to 127 and run it. Will it compile smoothly and print 127?
Yes.
Yes. If you make it 127, 127 is in the range of byte. Therefore, it will easily store it in B. And then that B in I. And then I printed. No issues. But just by making 127 to 128, it has gone beyond the limit. It has gone outside the limit. And it has thrown an error. It will give an error. You can try doing it. Getting? But let's talk about this. They are saying the program will compile, but will throw class cast exception. Please remember, guys, this exception never come in context of primitive data types. Means when you are converting one primitive to another, that time never this exception come. This exception come only when you are trying to cast one reference to another reference. See here. Like you already have a pizza object, new pizza, and you are trying to store it in a burger object, burger P equal to burger P. Okay? And suppose burger and pizza don't have any parent-child relation. Means they don't have any, compatibility. So compatibility meaning burger is the child of pizza. So if they don't have such relation, here the error will come. Which type of error? Class cast exception. Getting? So such exception never occur in case of primitives. This is the error occurring only when you try to convert one class object to another class. Getting? Means when the casting between one class and another class is happening, that time it comes. And the program will compile and print 255. Is it like that? Does it automatically widen? Automatic means automatically will it make it into upper category? No. It will loss, no? Because the value is only byte. Getting? It is clear to you guys. Yes or no? Just give me confirmation. In this, if you have any doubt, please tell me. Okay. Then one more we'll see quickly. See here. In this question, what will be the output of the following program? First, you have created one array with value 4816. But I'll just try to show you how this is internally in memory. Okay. Internally, this is your stack part, and this is the hip part. Always remember. Now, array topic we have to discuss, don't worry. There is one complete topic called arrays, we will be learning. Now, just remember, in Java, arrays will happen like that. Integer square array you have written. So, it will create one reference variable with the name array on the stack. Because in Java, arrays are also ref category. Means arrays are also objects according to Java. So it will create one array variable, a reference variable on the stack. And then right side you have written in a list 4, 8, 16. So it will create a 3 integer array. 3 size integer array on the hip. Getting? And here it's going to store 4, 8 and 16. And the reference of that array will come in this array variable. In this variable, the reference of this will come. Okay, this has happened. Now coming to this, integer I equal to 1. And then you are writing array plus plus array square bracket plus plus I equal to minus minus I. Okay, so whenever you are writing like this, array plus plus I equal to minus minus I. Here, is it going to do bracketing? I already told you, bracketing rule is applied. Okay? So after bracketing rule, can you tell me what is the result of this bracket? I is 1. So the result of this bracket is 2. And the result of this bracket is again 1. Do you agree with me or no? What yes. was value of I? 1. Then what is the result of this bracket? Plus plus I. Plus plus I. So will it make it 2? Right? I will become 2 and that 2 will come here. And minus minus I. Minus minus I. Will it again make it 1? Pre-increment, no? As it is pre-decrement. So it will decrement and give the value. So what is value? 1. Now it will go and store at array of 2, 1. Array of 2 equal to 1. So array of 2. See here. Array of 2 equal to 1. It will store 1 here. Getting guys? And now in your print statement, you are writing array of 0 plus array of 1 plus array of 2. So what is array of 0? What is array of 1? What is array of 2? Tell me. 4, 8 and 1. And if I add this 3, what will be the result guys? 4 plus 8 plus 1?
13.
13. Clear?
13.
And it will display 13. You got it? Is the rule clear to you? So first plus plus I is how much? 2. Minus minus I is 1. Array of 2 equal to 1. So array of 2 equal to 1 means this 16 becomes 1. And now when it adds it, it becomes 4 plus 8 plus 1, that is 13. Agreed? Hope it is clear to you people.
Yes, sir. Yes,
right?
Sir.
Right? Then in the next session, something more. Okay? So most probably in the next, tomorrow I'll take one session, one more. Right? Then we will take some relational operators, logical operators. Okay. So for today we have to stop, all of you. Thank you, all of you. Please take care.